Small eatery owners in Quezon City are struggling to get by under general community quarantine. Income has been halved from pre-COVID-19 days and customers are hard to come by.
Ang hilingin ko lang is ano eh, sana huwag nang bumalik tayo sa ano sa ECQ. Kasi mahirap eh. Hirap bumangon ang negosyo ngayon. Eh nag-ano pa lang kami ngayon eh. Nagbuwabangon pa lang.
Ay, balik po yung dati, tapos huwag po nila masyadong hikitan. Yung mga ibang biyahe po na mga bus, balik po nila.
Big business more or less have the same appeal.
There is so much unemployment. There is so much hardship. A lot of the MSMEs have already closed. I already surveyed the network. PCCI has a network of 120 local chapters. Last week, I spoke to each and every local chapter, and the situation is really, really bad. And the government and the congressmen and everybody should worry that once we have a lot of unemployment, we need to worry where our people will be able to get the money that they need for food, medicine, and other basic necessities. I have been pushing very hard since last week for the government to consider reopening the economy responsibly.
Analysts, meanwhile, simply want to hear concrete plans on how government would steer the Philippine economy out of the COVID-19 pandemic. BDO's Jonathan Ravelas wants details on stimulus and the revised infrastructure plan. President Rodrigo Duterte addressed their concerns in his fifth State of the Nation address Monday, but his answer may not have been what they were hoping for.
The loss of your incomes due to uncertainties in your jobs and livelihood, I assure you that your government will address squarely these problems and challenges to overcome them and proceed to a new normal. To open up the economy to pre-COVID-19 levels at this time is not an option because whatever good it can produce will only be gobbled up or be outweighed by the bad it will generate sometimes. Haste makes waste. Our economic managers have seen infrastructure investment as an effective tool to help spur high growth, attract investments, create jobs, and achieve financial inclusion for all. Low interest loans to our OFW. Nanawagan po ako sa ating mga lessors, malasakit at banayibayanihan po ang sana ang ipairalin natin ngayon.
Economist Calixto Chiquiamco says a lot of what the president mentioned in his nearly two-hour speech is not new, and the lack of detail was disappointing.
One is, of course, on the question of rising cases and overwhelming of hospitals. I did not hear any plan to really address that. How we will do that in a calibrated way so that it's going to be safe to open up the economy. The second bold plan that I was really looking forward to was really the matter of the worst economic recession that the country is facing in 35 years, with about 7.5 million people unemployed, and unemployment rate at the record 17%. That was as of April. So I did not see any bold plan to address that, except, of course, he mentioned a bit about CREATE, but CREATE is really our tax, represents tax cuts for companies that are profitable. But as DTI has surveyed, about 25% of MSMEs have shut down and about another 50% are just partially open. So they will not be able to enjoy the tax cuts under CREATE.
Duterte also spent time singling out corporations and business groups such as telco giants Globe and PLDT. Globe responded by detailing its $1.2 billion spending plan for 2020 and committing to improve its service to the public. AJ Montesa of Action for Economic Reform says this shows the president's lack of focus and contradicts his call for unity against COVID-19.
By name-dropping companies, it shows that he's more focused on settling some personal vendettas or settling some personal scores rather than actually addressing what the country is currently facing right now.
The business community, from small mom-and-pop stores to giant conglomerates and business groups, were all waiting for something new, something other than continued community quarantines and strict health measures and planned infrastructure spending to bolster their hopes for an economic recovery. But it seems they were disappointed. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.